Yeah. Hi guys, today we are going to look at the sampling and estimation methods overview. When it comes sampling, one minute, there is a audio noise. I think you may need to mute all of you. When it comes sampling, we may need to consider random variable. The moment sampling comes, randomness comes together. So that we may need to touch upon random variable. There are two types of random variable, discrete random variable, continuous random variable. One of the example for the distribution we have discussed already, 5-6 distribution, normal, Poisson distribution, binomial, Bernoulli distribution, uniform distribution, exponential distribution. Among all the distribution, discrete probability distribution, the best example is normal distribution. Continuous probability distribution is binomial distribution. These two are the example. What is discrete? What is continuous? Let us see bit by bit. The moment we say discrete, then it will become discrete variable. Always number of kids in at home, number of students attending the class, it is of discrete nature. We can't say continuous nature. It's a, we need to say 5 members, 7 members, 8 members, it will be represented in terms of integers, whole number. When it comes continuous, it will be in the form of real or floating number. That is a one indication. Now let us see example for why it is termed as randomness or random variable. When we need to choose it as a random variable, we need to have a glimpse or idea. For that, I'm just asking a question. The amount of rainfall in a particular area, I'm going to ask. The amount of rainfall, it will become crisp, only one value. Even particular area, particular date also, the rainfall from minimum to maximum, it will go. Exactly the rainfall will not become the number which we fix. So that is why it is randomness. For example, let us consider the mean value is 2.5. What is the probability of rainfall for x is equal to 2.01 mm? Exactly for that we are asking probability. What is the for example, I'm going to say roll number 801. What is the probability of getting exactly 85 marks? Roll number 3. What is the probability of getting exactly 85 marks? I'm going to ask. We cannot assure for single value. Rather, if I say that, what is the probability of the roll number 801 getting between the interval 80 to 90, as well as for 803 also, what is the probability of getting between the interval 80 to 90? If I ask question like that, the probability can be calculated. There is a chance for calculating probability. Rather, if I say precisely one particular number, probability would become zero, or maximum zero, or exactly it will become zero. Any word you can use. Because what is the guarantee that the exam is not at all conducted? For the business analytics, what is the probability of 801 is scoring exactly 80 marks? What is the probability of 803 roll number scoring exactly 85 marks? There is no problem. You may go up also, you may fail also, or you may go less also. Lot of probabilities are there. But exactly pointing that particular number, if I ask for probability, it would become zero. Rather, if I fix the interval between 80 to 100, between 60 to 100, if you look at, the probability will become more and more if the interval is increased. If I say 80 to 85, the probability will become 20%. If I say 80 to 90, the probability will become much more. If I say 80 to 100, much more. Rather than if I say the interval 60 to 90, 100% probability I can say. 801 and 803 both will have a chance to get the mark between 60 to 80. Could you get my point? So that is why it is called random variable, randomness. So now the random variable associated with a single value always zero. When you can say random variable is a variable having multiple values. For example, now for 801, 803, if I give the interval 60 to 90 marks, if I fix the interval, getting business analytics marks after the end examination, what is the probability between scoring 60 to 90? How many values are there? 60, 61, 62. Put all the values. So many values are there. So this is called random variable. You guys will get a mark between the interval 60 to 90, any mark or any value. Could you get my point? Rather than this interval, if I fix exactly 80 mark, exactly 83, neither it should become more than that, nor it should become less than that. Then the probability would become zero. We can't predict like that. We can predict between the interval. I can say if the candidate is doing well, responding well, learning well, then I can fix 80 and above, or 70 and above I can fix naturally. So there is an interval, 70 to 100. If the candidate is studying normal or average, I can fix between 50 to 70. If the candidate is studying very poor, I can fix from 0 to 50. So this is how it works. I can't fix any one of the roll number picking, you will get exactly 0. I can't say. Before the examination, before seeing the question paper, before even your preparation mode and effort, I cannot determine that. So that is called random variable. Let us see one by one. Now look at lesser values of the mean will occupy left hand side. This is the left hand side. Look at this is the mean. Always in the normal distribution, exactly the peak, middle of the peak is represented by mean 2.5. Now the lesser values of mean will occupy left of the mean. 1 minute, there is a mistake. I need to correct. Actually, it was correct. Zigzagged. This alignment. Yeah, now it is correct. Left of the mean, whereas greater value will occupy right of the mean. For example, if I calculate average marks of your class, that average mark or mean value will be represented here. Any one of you getting higher score, all the highest score or greater than the mean will fall into right hand side of the normal distribution. All the lesser value will fall into left hand side of the normal distribution. It's through common sense we can understand. Now look at the area at 2.0. What is the meaning probability is area calculation. Area for this single line, what would become? Look at this. The cross line will come. Area will for this single line, normally it would be zero. Because of this area zero only, we are trying to tell probability zero. Not because of, sometimes there is a possibility also. Precisely I can fix 803 will get 86 mark, I can fix also. Because I am teaching, I know the attitude of 803, I know the learning inclination, I know the sample mark and conducting mid 1, mid 2, I can fix it. It will happen. Practically it will happen, I am trying to tell. But technically it will not happen. Because technically the area for that particular single value will become zero. That is why it is zero. Area means what? This area under curve in the previous session we have discussed one. Then if I am in the position to calculate area between these two lines, I can calculate. Area, this left hand side of the first line or second line, I can calculate. Area is a larger portion, not at a single point it is possible to calculate the area. So that we need to remember. Now let us move on. Always we need to remember this probability or area calculation is possible only within the range. For the range only we can calculate. Look at now, probability of 2.01, the random variable x, what is the probability between these two values? That is the final explanation. The maximum value is 2.5, the minimum value is 2.01. This is for rainfall. If it is your mark, I will give you one more example for your mark. Now, in this scenario, this is a given problem statement. What is the probability of the rainfall between 2.5 to 2.01? Are between 2.01 to 2.5. Any way you can represent, but it is lying within the range. For that, it is possible to calculate for lesser value using R or Excel. 1 minute, something went wrong. Calculate. Is it visible, Ashwita? The first slide. Now is it visible? I closed it.
Document.
Yeah, now 2.01, it is visible, na? 2.01 yes, to 2.5. Okay, ma'am. Now we are trying to calculate x is less than or equal to 2.5. Only this is possible to calculate when it becomes R code or it becomes Excel code. So what is the other way to calculate greater than? Then 1 minus, naturally probability means greater than is represented or equivalent to 1 minus, what is this? This we need to calculate. So this is the way we can calculate the probability. So now it is possible to find out probability with the given mean value and given standard deviation. Only then it is possible. Right now I'm just taking a lead. Next we are going to solve one example, through that you can understand. Always the probability is possible to calculate, or random variable can work within the interval, within the range. So within that range it is possible through R and Excel code to calculate only for lesser than value. This left hand side only we can calculate. How to calculate for the right hand side? You need to always, greater than is given, you need to use this method, 1 minus p of x less than or equal to 2.01. For these two language, this is the only way, no other way, R code or Excel code. Now let us first consider one of the problem, then you will come to know exactly all other concepts. Look at, find the probability that a normally distributed random variable, now I am taking the case marks of students, has a mean of 60. What is the meaning mean of 60 is, most of the students in your class trying to score 60 and above, are nearby 60, 50 to 60, that mark is available. That is why mean value becomes 60. And standard deviation is sigma is equal to 10. You need to get these two parameters. Only then you can calculate the probability. Mean and standard deviation is essential. These two are essential to calculate what to say, the probability value. This is essential. And we want to find the probability that x is less than 70 mark. Exactly, I am giving one mark or one particular candidate or one particular mark I am choosing. For that, I need to find out the probability. Compute finally, x is less than or equal to 70. This is called x. This value which is given to calculate is called x. The value which is given or essential for calculating the probability are mu is equal to 60. Standard deviation sigma is equal to 10. Now let us see. Excel, you need to use the function called normdist. Normdist consists of four parameters. What are the parameters? X. What is X in your given sample? 70 mark. What is the mean value? Explicitly given. Mean is equal to 60. Standard deviation, what is given? Very explicitly given. X is sigma is equal to 10. This one you need to represent. This is mandatory as per the, what to say, Excel command. What that one represents is probability density function or cumulative normal distribution, the area under the curve is 1. That means we are considering normal distribution. This 1 signifies normal distribution. That's all. That area under the curve for any normal distribution is 1. This is a basic thumb rule. Depending upon that only we are using. If you are versatile with R code, you can use the command pnorm x, mean, standard deviation. Here we no need to mention this. Now let us calculate. Now how we can calculate, let me take, I'll stop share and I'll go to the Excel, I'll show you. Look at this, this is the value. Norm distance 70, 60, 10, 1. X is 70, mean is 60, standard deviation is 10 and area under curve 1, this is the syntax, is 1. So if I substitute this, you will be getting this mark. 1 minute, something wrong. Yeah, this is the mark. Now let us calculate for the same class mean. Based on the mean only it calculates. Mean value only guides for this probability. Now what is the probability of getting 70 is 84%. This is called 84%. Next let us calculate probability of getting less than 60, the probability would become more, I guess, because average is 60. If I am asking for less than 60, naturally it will become more. let us calculate 59. X is 59, comma, norm dist. I need to put 1 minute. Syntax norm dist is equal to norm dist. I need to write the command norm dist. So first 59 mean is what? 1 minute. Mean is 60, I guess. Mean is 60, standard deviation is 10. Yeah, mean is 60, comma, standard deviation is 10, comma, 1. This is a syntax. 46%, it is going lesser. 46%, 59. Let us try one more thing. Is equal to norm dist. We can understand the relationship between the mean and the value which we are going to choose. Let us give 79, comma, 60, comma, 10, comma, 1. So 97%. So that signifies most of the students are doing well. If I give more mark, it is giving more confidence or more percentage. If I give lesser mark, it gives lesser confidence. Look at, we started for finding out 59 so that we are getting the confidence or interval 46%. For this, we are getting 84. For this, we are getting 97. What that signifies is most of the students in that class trying to get above 60 marks. Because of that above 60 marks only, whenever the value we are giving for X, you are getting more percentage. See, the value which I passed is 79. Confidence is, or the percentage is 97. Now let us do norm dist of 84, comma, 60, comma, 10, comma, 1. 99%. Because mean value is 60. Yeah, mean value is 60. That mean value we have obtained because of the distribution which are all having more than 60. Now, not only mean value helps us, standard deviation as well helps us. These two together says for the percentage of our probability calculation. 84% confidence, 47% confidence, 97% confidence, 99% confidence. Why we are going for probability? Anything to predict earlier. What would happen in order to predict earlier, the probability is used. So based on the mean value and the influence of standard deviation only, it is possible to calculate this percentage. Hope so you would be getting this point. Now let us move back with the slide, with the material presentation. So this is the R code. This is how we are telling 84%. R code we have calculated. Similarly, to find X greater than 90, we need to use 1 minus X less than or equal to 70. See why we had gone more value. Look at here, greater than 70, if you are calculating, we need to do 1 minus. If you do 1 minus, you would be getting the appropriate distribution. Never it is possible to get X is less than it is possible. X is less than you can obtain. This is the value represented. X is less than 70. Always greater than if you want to calculate. In the Excel sheet also calculated less than 80, less than 90, less than 99, less than 89, something like that. So less than only it is possible to calculate. Greater than if you want to calculate, we need to go for 1 minus. Whatever in the Excel sheet, it is being shown for several values of X. Everywhere, if you are interested to calculate above 80, then you need to go for 1 minus. If it is less than 80 only, this why that percentage became so high? 99 also you got. Because any value doesn't matter, less than 90 has been given. Any value, your mark can be 0, your mark can be 1, your mark can be exactly 95, that doesn't matter. We are giving wide scope so that the confidence or the percentage is becoming more. That's all. Now let us see this. X is greater than 70, 1 minus 70. This drawn line, the slanting lines are less than 70 area is more. Less than 70 area is more. Above 70 area is lesser. So whenever greater than you want to calculate this region, if you want to calculate, 1 minus is the value you need to substitute. Well, if you put 1 minus, then you would be getting for greater than value. See, this area under the curve is 1. This is the area for less than. Then do that. 1 minus is less than, you will get this area value. That's all. Now the turn has come to you. You may need to calculate. There is a GMAT examination. Scores can be reasonably modeled with a normal distribution with the mean value of your parameters are mean is equal to 711, standard deviation equal to 29. Now you need to calculate what is the probability of obtaining a mark or GMAT score x less than or equal to 680. You need to calculate and give me. If you have R code also, you can calculate. Excel also, you can calculate. X is less than are equal to 680. As I mentioned earlier, greater than you can't calculate based on this probability distribution. If at all anyone gives you greater than symbol, you need to calculate for the less than and 1 minus you need to compute. Take for a while or 1 minute. I'll give 1 minute. I'm going to apply pass. You need to calculate and tell me the probability of the x value for less than 680. Greater than, let us calculate later. Don't worry about this part. This part I want it now. Right now, I'll give you 1 minute of time. You need to calculate and come out with the answer. You can use either R code or you can use R Excel. See, this is the R code for calculating probability for the random variable. This is the Excel code. Whichever you feel so, you can calculate. Just recently only you have completed R. So that I'll pause for a moment, 45 seconds. Let me copy paste that formula near to the problem, then I will give you the timings. So this is the code. I'm copying pasting here nearby so that you can refer and you can calculate. So you have the problem statement here, mean value, standard deviation value and the x value is 680. You have the Excel command and you have the R code command, so you can start calculating. So start the
हेलो 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 मैम,
हाय गाइस, हैव यू कैलकुलेटेड? पोस्ट द आंसर इन द चैट विंडो और यू कैन अनम्यूट एंड गिव मी द आंसर. आई वांट आंसर.
हेलो,
या
मीन इज 1.96 मैम।
मीन आई आस्क्ड यू टू कैलकुलेट प्रोबेबिलिटी ना. सी मीन आई हैड गिवन, व्हाई यू कैलकुलेट? स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन आई हैड गिवन, व्हाई यू कैलकुलेट? आई वांट द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ 684.
मैम 0.14 आई थिंक। ओ देन इट इज 0. इट इज इफ योर मीन इज 1.96 देन हेलो हेलो मैम हेलो
What is this? It's actually, I was using college internet. Suddenly it went disappeared. Then I started giving my internet. That is a delay. Have you calculated the answer? Yes, sir. Have you calculated the answer?
Hello?
Yeah.
Ma'am, probability is 1.643, ma'am.
1.64, no,
0.14. Yes, ma'am. 0.14, I thought, ma'am.
Yeah, that is correct. Exact answer. I'll copy paste this and I will show you in the Excel. I'll show you in the Excel. See, look at, I'm going back to the Excel. Look at, this is the problem statement. I'm just pasting here. I need to give equal to norm dist of, first I need to give you mean value. Mean value is, x value. X value is 680. First. Comma 711 mean value, standard deviation 29, comma 1. Only here we will use 1. 1 minute, what norm distance, m is missing, m. Yeah, now it will come. This is the final value. This is what I have obtained. 0.1425 is the final answer. What Ashwita only said, na? This answer. Yeah, correct.
No, ma'am. It's Shweta.
Shweta, okay, yeah, for two, this 810 and 805, right answer. So this is the final answer. Simple calculation, we are not doing anything. We need to give feed to the Excel or R code. R code, if you are using different command. So that R code I am not showing right now. This is only I am showing. So this is the value for probability of x less than. No need of manual calculation. Manual calculation, even I don't know. So this is the input plug-in function we are doing. Manual calculation, it could be different. Okay. Now, let us do for x greater than or equal to 780. You need to do now. X greater than or equal to 780. I will paste it here itself. Now you need to do. What is 780? How, first tell me, how you need to rewrite this? Is it possible to calculate for 780 first? Greater than 780, is it possible to calculate using Excel and R code?
No,
yes,
ma'am.
Or no? No.
No.
No, ma'am.
Yeah. Now how to calculate? Tell me the answer.
One minus
this exactly less than, that's all. Only I need to flip less than. Yeah, you can mute. That's all. This is what you need to calculate. Give me the answer. We are going to calculate greater than. It is not possible. So that we are trying to calculate for less than. From the less than, we need to go with the formula 1 minus. After 1 minus, you need to tell me the answer. Take a few moments. Then... take few moments and calculate norm dist, that is the function. If you have Excel R code, if you have, use this command pnorm. Just plug in what are all the values available. Just plug in, no more your things you are doing. See, x is the value given in the x here, it is represented clearly. Then you have mean, you have standard deviation. You need to plug in into pnorm. Only one code in R, just to run the command. That's all, you will get the answer. Otherwise, go to Excel and calculate and give me the answer. First, you find the answer for P of x less than 730 and go for 1 minus subtraction. Give me the final answer. Guys, did you get the answer for this? Yeah, now only I could see 0.743. No, not
0.7.
66.64. No.
Sorry, 0.66.64. That's what I got when calculating.
No, Excel you can use or R code you can use, no? So the obtained value is 2.26. Let us calculate this. Only the earlier change is 7:30. Look at. I don't know what software you guys are using. Absolutely wrong. See, here I am changing only 7:30 is equal to, this is not my value. Let us delete. So U is equal to norm dist of value 7:30. I think someone need to mute. There is a lot of noise. I feel headache. Come up one. See, you are getting 0.74. You need to do 1 minus equal to 1 minus. What is the value? L cell L10. L10. That's all. See, 0.256 I'm getting. This is what my answer. Right in front of you, I'm calculating. How you guys are calculating, I can't understand. Finally, I want 1 minus, no? That also you should do, no? So 0.7438, right? Absolutely right. 38, this is right. Then 1 minus. Final answer, I want this. That's what I said, no? Final answer is required or essential. 1 minute. Could you get the way I'm calculating? Yes, is there any doubt on it? Yeah. Then let's move on. 1 minute. Word file is visible, ma? Now, word file.
Yes, ma'am, it is visible.
Yeah, that's all. See, we thumb rule always register in your mind. Mean value we recover, standard deviation we recover. Then what is a random value we are taking? That random value always it is possible to calculate only for less than. Never it is possible to calculate for greater than. I don't know about other language. Using R and Excel, never it is possible. So that the tactics which we are using, always if we know P, what is the way we calculate in the probability? Childhood mathematics, nothing more great. 1 minus P. This is the way we calculate childhood mathematics probability. The moment you know P, you can calculate Q. So that is what we are doing. This is called P. This is called Q. We are subtracting 1 minus P of X less than 7:30. Someone of you given right value, 805.7438, right answer, but that is not sufficient. I was expecting 1 minus. This is how you need to calculate. Why these are all the probability is calculated? See, for example, we used to deal with one-on-one. Suppose I want to borrow your money from you. I am asking 803 to give me 50,000 rupees. Now itself, today itself, you need to give me 50,000 rupees. I'm trying to tell. For the loan, I may pay, interest also, or without interest, whatever. She'll be calculating probable value of whether I will be paying back. First of all, see, you people will be very cautious whenever you are giving money. First question is, you are not even bothered about interest, first of all. You will be calculating what is the probability that Dr. Lakshmi would give back the money exactly as per the specified date. First of all, you will question whether she will give or not. Whether I am giving the deadline, October 30th, I will pay you back, I am telling. So first, your thought process would be probability. Every day we are calculating probability, but you are not sensitizing, that's all. You will first calculate whether she will pay back or not. Second, you will calculate within the stipulated time she will pay back or not, because you have some commitment based on that 50,000 you want to do in November month, Diwali, so many festivals you may purchase. Third question only in your mind, will she pay the interest properly or not? These are all the three questions you will raise in your mind if I ask 50,000. What you are doing is you are calculating probability. If your mind says highest probability she will pay back, you will give me the money. If you don't have trust on me, you will say, so sorry, I don't have money. That is how you are working. For the prediction only, we are using probability. Understand that first. So why we are calculating this GMAT score, rainfall or about your mark score, why do we do? It is a kind of prediction, precaution. Even weather prediction, every day I'll be looking into mobile app. I have mobile app, weather app. So based on that app only, I used to wash my clothes. Why I am looking into that app? Whether the sunny day is available or not, probability of sunny day. If the probability is more, I will wash my clothes. So how that app is predicting? Based on these are all the calculation. That app is reliable, only then I am looking into the app. But how that app is doing? These are all the mathematics going behind of the app. So that is how we need to interpret these are all the problems. GMAT score, why we are doing this. Imagine I'm running a coaching center. I know about your internal performance. Past 3 months, I'm conducting exam for you. I know your attitude, your performance, your learning inclination. I need to judge in prayer what would happen in future. Because my tuition center or coaching center reputation is dependent upon the batch I am handling. So whether I need extra coaching or I require something, either support or what is the way I need to work on with your batch, I need to calculate. For that only we are doing, these are all the estimations, these are all the calculation. That is the ultimate answer. You need to understand why I am doing. Now let us move on to further. So I hope so it is sufficient, because 2-3 problems we solved. So here also I chosen randomly so many values. First we have calculated for less than 70. See, x is less than 70. Always you seek for this word. Whether in the given problem people are saying less than 70 or greater than 70. If it is both are fine, that is not a big challenge. Greater than 70 means we need to do 1 minus. Less than means the computer value we can write down. So either you need to do R code or you need to go for P norm. There is a formula for these all. With that formula, you can calculate x minus mu divided by standard deviation. Something will come. So with that formula, you can do. Instead, we are going for calculation through Excel and R code. So these days, we have these are all the options. So that we are going for 0.84. So when it is less than, directly you can do. When it is greater than, you need to compute and you need to go for 1 minus. So we didn't do for this. Simply subtraction, you can do it later. Then taking GMAT score, that particular batch mean we are taking. Maybe 40 students may be studying with me, or 80 students they may be studying with me. It doesn't matter. Whomever, what is the N is not required for us to calculate probability calculation. This GMAT score of number of students 80, it could be number of students 10 or number of students 100. That is not a botheration for us. We are given the value mean and standard deviation. We are asked to compute the value for score less than or equal to 680. Then the probability or the possibility is 0.14. If it is greater than or equal to 730, we need to calculate less than or equal to 730, 1 minus. Hope so you would be understanding. Now let us move for a little bit, another 5-10 minutes only I'll be addressing. Inferential statistics. Already the same picture, same phenomena I have brought. Population is a larger. For example, I want to understand whether male students are doing well with respect to business analytics or female students are doing well with respect to business analytics. This is the problem statement. I need to conduct a research. In this research, I first find out who are all the students doing business analytics. Next, boundary condition. Whether I need to do within the state Telangana or across India or across the globe, that in the problem statement need to be specified very clearly. Or within BBRIT, that determines my population. From the population, I can try doing our data collection for the entire population size itself I can do if it is possible. If it is BBRIT alone, definitely population will be available. In irrespective of the batch, irrespective of the year and department, I can collect business analytics data. If it is Telangana, little bit tough. Then I need to pick up whichever the institutions are nearby me, that again sampling techniques are different. Let us see later. Entire Telangana, how many colleges are running the course business analytics? I need to take the survey. Then I need to collect the data. If it is India, again I need to think, entire India, all the colleges, is it possible? Not at all possible. Rather, I can do, in every state, I can pick randomly few of the institutions who are all offering business analytics. I can collect the data, both female and male. Finally, I can take decision, or I can do statistical analysis. Finally, I can conclude male students are doing well or female students are doing well. This is called inferential statistics. Then whatever we are doing on the sample, those all are said to be inferential. A decision, estimation or prediction we are doing on the sample and generalized about a population. Already I said vaccination. Till date, COVID vaccination study is going on with different, they want to see the side effect in shorter duration and the longer duration. Maybe up to 6 months, the observation is considered. After 6 months only, that vaccination will come into the approval. They didn't put that vaccination for all the people. They have drawn the sample for the sample or those people they have administered that vaccination. Then they are doing the observation. Every month they are looking at their all the bioparameters. Then is there any other side effect they are observing? So based on that only, they are concluding whether that vaccination is good for human race or not. Then that will come into the action for the larger population. Then everyone can go for COVID vaccination or this coronavirus vaccination. This is called generalization. From the sample, the population is generalized. That is called inferential statistics. Whatever we are doing most of the time in the data analytics, it is of inferential statistics. We need to understand what is sampling, what is estimation method, what is population sample. Hope so by this time you can understand what is population, what is samples, what is sampling. Estimation method we are going to look at. Then these are all the scientific notation we should be in the position to understand. Whenever mu is given, that is population mean. Whenever x bar is given, that is sample mean. Whenever sigma is given, that is standard deviation of population. Whenever S is given, that is sample. Look at, in this example, whatever we have considered, all are related to population. That is a caution, or that is what you need to understand. Look at, I had given the symbol mu, I had given the symbol sigma. In this problem as well, it is given mean and standard deviation. So here as well, we need to consider only the population. Next to variance. Population variance is represented with sigma square. Sample variance is represented with a square. Population proportion is pi. Sample proportion is p. Now comes to the discussion, types of sampling. We already discussed across India. I want to understand who is doing better business analytics, whether female students are doing better or male students are doing better. By the time sampling comes to the picture, if only for BVR-AT, no more sampling technique. Population itself I can continue because it is internal, accessible. If the data is missing also, I can impute, I can understand, I can go for survey, I can call people, I can mail people, or I can refer old database, or I can refer old teachers who are all working in that institution. Anything can happen. But when it becomes larger, sample that population size is too huge, then I need to go for sampling technique. Simple random sampling. As I said, across India, randomly I need to pick 2-3 colleges from every state. I need to collect the data. That is random sample. Next, another technique is cluster sampling. I can form group 1, group 2, group 3, group 4 based on the group collection, grouping states, South India, North India, Southeast India. Like that, I can group. Within that cluster, I can draw few samples. That is called clustering. Next is convenience sampling. This is my convenience. In any one of the college, my friend may be the HOD, my friend may be the principal, or I know few of the students in that college. Depending upon my convenience, my availability, I can collect the data. That is convenience sampling. Always, whenever we are doing statistical report or projects or research, we need to mention about the sample size. What is population? How we did sampling? For that only I'm telling you, sir. Next is stratified random sampling. Convenient sampling, most of the people will be doing either convenient sampling or they will be doing simple random sampling. This is the famous sampling technique. Next is stratified sampling. What is stratified sampling is we need to identify different variety, then equally, more or less equally, we need to sample. For example, I'm doing India wide, then business analytics who are all doing well, then what and all the thing I need to consider, religion, age or gender, it should become equal. Suppose if I am biasing all the women institution, I am collecting the data, very few only co-ed college I am considering. What would happen? It would be biased. Then my result would say women students are doing better. So that should not be. If at all I am doing gender study, then definitely more or less equal proportion I need to collect the data. So that is called sampling technique, or that is a thumb rule of sampling technique. Here it is stratified sampling. I need to group them and I need to draw from each category. See, look at one example. Ecological regions, development regions, rural or urban, sex ratio, age, caste or ethnicity. Whenever these are all the combinations are required, then we need to go for stratified sampling. Otherwise, not required. Equal proportion, who is doing well. For example, election, that is required. For business analytics, this much information, religion wise and all, I don't require. Election, which religion is voting for me? Which gender is voting for me? Whether I'm getting more vote from urban population or rural population. These are all the kind of information I want to take for next campaign. So that these all required. By the time sampling we need to take, I need to go for survey with ecological region, few people based on the regions, development region, then rural or urban region, based on the gender, based on the age, 18 and above, you are eligible for voting. Then I need to go for different bandwidth of age group people for understanding preference of my party. Whether that particular person is preferring my party or not. Next, caste or ethnicity. So this is called stratified. Then we need to balance equally more or less all the category. Let us say, for example, this is urban, this is rural, this is for religion, something like that. If I keep, it should become equalized from every strata. This is called strata. This is one segment is called strata. So this is one segment strata. So I need to pull the sample from each and every strata equally before conducting the experiment. This has equal proportion. One from here, one from here, one from some or bunch. Bunch of this, bunch of this, bunch of this available. So this is the sample I can consider for my research. That's all. Sampling property. First, it should become unbiased. For example, I am going for conducting a survey, business analytics, whether male candidate is doing well, female candidate is doing well. Then I am collecting all the data only from the women institution. Then what is the meaning? I am biased. I am favor of women. So that is the indication, should become unbiased, independent. Selection of one unit has no influence on selection of other unit. We should not influence. For example, I'm going and conducting BVRIT college, then students or the faculty should not influence. We have one more sister concern, BVRIT Hyderabad also, go and take. That kind of influence should not be there. So randomly we need to do. Simple random sampling is a golden standard against all other sampling method. So finally, scientists concluded simple random sampling is the best method. That is a golden standard, they are telling. Sampling frame. Frame means size. So also what is the frame, sample frame, entirely the population itself you are going to get, or you are going to differ. The list is going to differ for the sample. So that is the term called sampling frame. For example, if I want to understand female male student of BVR80 students, then there is no frame. Entire population itself my sample. Then it becomes statewide. Then I need to fix the frame. 80% of the samples I have considered, because I am given the time, 1 year of time to collect the data in my research study. So that I need to consider 80% of the sample. Only the colleges which are all not cooperating or I am not able to reach them, I can eliminate. Rest all the college I need to fix. If the time duration given for my research is only 6 months, then I need to consider at least 50% of the institutions. So that is called sampling frame. 1/3, 1/4, or 1/6, 1/8, 1/9 of the population which you are considering, you need to take decision. Based on the population only, you need to decide the frame size. Now, sample variation. So if the sample is lesser, variation would become more. For example, I am taking only 20% of the institution, then variation will become more. Always sampling should become more or less near to the population, only then variation will become lesser. That is a thumb rule. Then based on the research on, means time frame or convenient of the researcher only, everything will happen. With that note, let us continue with the next class from this sampling variation, how that sampling variation affects the research and what are all the ways statistical inferences we can do. What is the role of central limit theorem in the in the calculation or in the prediction. So these are all the point and the confidence interval. These are all we are going to discuss. This one particular point alone I will be addressing at the end after completion of this. Now, estimation, we are going for point estimation and interval estimation. One point only I will be covering first. Subsequently, we are going for hypothesis test. So with that unit one, we are going to conclude. See you guys. I'm going to end the recording. Yeah.